So in this video, I want to talk a little bit about how to build up a basic mental ray shader tree and what some of the differences are between the mental ray component shaders and the Maya monolithic shaders. So this is a scene that we've used before, and what I've done in this scene just to set it up is I've set it up so that I have an image-based lighting node, an IBL node in there, and the IBL node is simply one of the spherical reflection maps that we've used in previous videos. So the render of it looks like this. I just have three Lambert materials assigned to these three objects, or this one Lambert material. So I'm going to start off with a mental ray blend material. So I'll just come down MIB illumination blend, and I'll drop that onto the sphere. So we can just take a look at this. And really what we start to see is this kind of blown out highlight. I do have a number of lights in this scene. So this highlight really shouldn't be as blown out as it is. It shouldn't be as bright as it is. And when I look at the different attributes, I can pretty easily see why. What I want is the ambience and the ambience multiplied by the ambient, and the two of those added to the diffuse and the specular, and the total of those values should not be greater than one. And right now they're far greater than one. By virtue of the ambience and the ambient, my shader is a little bit self-illuminating. So I'm going to just go ahead and drop that down to zero, so I can deal just with the diffuse and the specular. I'm also getting, still getting this this blown out look, and that has to do with the roughness and the index of refraction. On a blend material, the index refraction has a lot of control over the specular highlight. This is not like glass. If I take the index of refraction and I bring it all the way up to 2, for example, I'm really not getting very much. But if I bring that up to maybe a 10, I should start seeing a little bit of a difference. I can see it down here, but I'm still a little bit too blown out over here to be able to see anything. So I'll take the diffuse down a little bit. I'll take the specular down a little bit so that we can start to see a little bit more of that highlight there. So now, you know, the highlight is controlled not only by the specular value here, but by the roughness value. We saw in an earlier video that when I increase that roughness, it spreads that that diffuse out. It spreads that specular out. When I bring it down, it tightens it up a little bit. Okay, so so that's the basic blend material, but we're still not getting any reflections. There's no reflection attribute in the material at all. So that's the next thing that I want to set up. So I'll just select this blend material, and I'll show my input and output connections so that we can see. Now, the blend material feeds into this shading group node, and down at the bottom of the shading group node, you'll see that there's a material shader here called MIB Illumination Blend 1. That's going to be pretty important for us. So in the mental ray section over here, under the sample compositing section, I have a number of these sample shading components here, and one of them is the MIB reflect. So that's the one that I want. You can see that the MIB reflect has an input and a reflection, an input value and a reflectance value. So this reflectance value corresponds to the Maya reflectivity value. What I need to do is replace the material shader that's identified in the shading group node with this reflection shader. So I'll drag this over and just drop it right into the blend shading group. So now a render is going to show pure reflection here. There's no diffuse, there's no specularity, there are none of the attributes that this blend material carried with it. So in order to combine both of these components in the same shader tree, I'm going to want to drag this blend over to the input section of my reflection shader. The reflection shader in and of itself does not have its own shading engine or shading group. So you really have to start out with one of the illumination models. that will give you the shading group by default, and then you just go ahead and replace the material shader with the reflection. You plug the material shader back into the reflectance, into the reflection shader. So let's do let's tear this panel off and do a couple of little test renders here. I'll just do an IPR render so that we can see what's happening here. One of the really interesting things about the this shading model right here is that it automatically gives us a balance between the attributes of the blend and the reflection. So the reflectance, the amount of reflectance, as that increases and gets closer and closer to one, what happens is the amount of the blend material decreases, so that by the time I get all the way to one, I have a purely reflective shader. Notice also that I'm getting a little bit of a ray trace reflection of this other cylinder reflected in there. So I'm reflecting not only the IBL background, but I'm reflecting the objects in the scene. Let's just make a couple of other adjustments so that we can see this a little bit more clearly. I'm going to take the diffuse attribute here, and I'm going to make this a fairly strong color. I'll come in and make it a blue here. And that has no effect in my IPR render because I have my reflectivity set all the way up to 1. As I start to decrease that reflectivity, the diffuse attribute starts to peek through. And remember from previous videos that our diffuse attribute is really the actual color of the object peeking through. So I can start to see my specular highlight here. I can start to see the color, and the color of the object is balanced with the amount of reflectivity. So this is really a nice energy conserving model here. Within the reflectance shader, I can turn no trace to on, and that will eliminate any ray trace reflections. Let's just let's rotate this around so we can see a little bit more clearly. So here I have no ray tracing turned on, and when I turn no trace to off, I can see my other objects reflected in the sphere. I can control more of the reflections that appear in this blend material here. When I go into my IBL node here and look at my render stats, I have a checkbox for the primary visibility, visible as environment, and visible in secondary reflections. So with all those turned on, I'm seeing my environment in the background here, and I'm seeing the reflection here, and I'm seeing the ray trace reflection of the cylinder. If I select the IBL node and I turn off the primary visibility, I'll still see the reflections of it, but I won't see the background as an image plane. So this is a really good way of compositing against a background. Then if I turn off my visible as environment and visible in secondary reflections, I'm not going to see that being reflected in here at all. So I can actually see this as a background image by turning on the primary visibility, but I won't see any of those environmental reflections. I'll only see the ray trace reflections. Notice how the diffuse here becomes that much stronger. Even in my reflection material, I have my reflections turned up fairly high. There's nothing to reflect, so there's nothing to compensate for, so I get 100% of contribution from my diffuse. So again, going back to the IBL node here, I'll turn on my environment and my secondary reflections, and now we'll see that it's balanced again. Of course, our reflectivity is going to be angle dependent based on our eye rays. So we know this to be the Fresnel effect, and we can add the Fresnel effect in exactly the same way we've done it with a Maya shader. I'll go into the Maya Utilities nodes, I'll find a Sampler Info node, and then in my 2D textures I'll create a ramp. I'm going to drag the Sampler Info node onto the ramp, and connect the facing ratio to the V coordinate. You should be very used to this by now. And then if just to be able to see what I'm doing, I'll select a surface material, I'll create a surface shader, and I'll drag the ramp onto that surface shader and make that the default. So now I want to think of these colors as the reflectivity here. I know that I want most of my reflectivity to be around the outside, which is where the red is. So I'll make that maybe a, maybe a 60% gray, so I get a fair amount of reflectivity there. I'll delete the green and I'll make the blue area relatively non-reflective, so I'll make that sort of a dark brown. I don't need that surface shader anymore, so I'll take this ramp and I'm going to just drag that on and have that control the reflectivity. And it works exactly the same way that a Maya material works. So let's just do a quick render. And you can see that my reflection is angle dependent. Let's rotate this back around and do an IPR render here. And now we can see that by changing this ramp, let's make this a an exponential down. So I have less reflection around the middle part here, and I have more reflection on the outer part. We can bring that all the way up to 1, and you can see that I'm balancing this reflectivity pretty substantially. Around here we have a lot more reflection than we have in the inside. So, and this automatically balances the reflectivity with the diffuse.